There are only a few great rock stars, even fewer mega stars, perhaps only a handful of rock legends. So it gives me great pleasure to introduce one of the only mega legendary star rockers, the great, not late, Eric Daly. Yeah.
It's marvelous. It's marvelous to. It's marvelous.
It's marvelous to have one of the great rock stars of all time. But let's go back to your early career. For perhaps the younger viewers may not have be familiar.
Yeah, with well, you. As you know, I started very, very young at school with Reg and Jez.
Yeah.
We were just mucking around with skiffle, yaha, a bit of lila.
Yeah. Music,
a lot of that old Ethiopian sound, which we had in before it got fashionable.
Yes. This was the corduroys, of course.
The corduroys, yeah. That was the first group. Yeah. God bless them.
Yeah. And, now, of course, Jez was the motivating force behind
it. Well, Jez, God bless him, Jez... Some would say he was the creative one of the three. I mean, without Jez, we would have just been a duo.
Yes.
So with Jez, there were three of us there. Yeah. We all had our little battles.
Yeah.
Our little battles. We had our little, he wrote the songs that were immediately available to...
The successful songs.
The one, yes.
Well, your ones didn't really...
Ours were more the sort of early white noise type of...
Yeah. Yeah.
That sort of, the sort of sound you can't get into at once. It's the sort of sound you can only get into years later.
Yeah. if then.
Well, it's avant-garde. But Jez was, he was the one with the...
Talent?
Tune.
Yeah, the tune.
Melodically, he had the tune. But looking back on those records, or listening to them even, you get a feeling of the times.
Yeah.
You get a feeling of everything was full of hope.
It was the 60s, wasn't it?
It was a time of rejoicing, a feeling of... You could do anything if you just tried.
Yeah.
And Jez tried and died, we tried and died.
Yeah. Fair enough. But in the 70s, of course, you went on to form one of the first supergroups.
Yeah, Ye Gods.
Yes.
It was one of the, I suppose, the first great all-white supergroup.
Yeah.
They were just me and some other people I brought in into the group who were very good in their own right. There was a little boy we found in Pittsburgh.
Yeah.
Blind Tony Dindin.
Yes.
And just a little kid, he's about 8 years old, and he played like a dream, a dream. He'd do...
He was a drummer, was he?
No, it was vocals.
It
was a dream. But we never toured, because we could never find the venues.
Yeah.
Because those were the days of... I say it myself. I mean, it's on the public record. I've done a lot of drugs.
Yes.
I've done a lot of drugs, and I've slept with a lot of women.
Yeah.
And boys and girls at home don't.
Yeah.
If you think that by sleeping with thousands of women and taking thousands of drugs, you're going to have a good time, let me just say this. Don't. Because I'm telling you, I just got out of the Henry Ford Clinic. And
Henry Ford Clinic?
Yes.
Not the Betty Ford?
No, the Henry one is a much tougher regime. Yeah. You have to build a car before you're allowed out. But seriously, scrub your own toilets and read your own newspapers and everything like that. And thank God, just for today, I'm clean and sober.
Yeah.
And I would not like it to be any other way.
No.
So don't.
Yeah. So all
whatever
right, so
you do,
so
don't.
That's your message. Now in the '70s, you
just say maybe.
Yeah. Now, what's the Ye Gods? Of course, your big hit, the one that most people know.
I love it. Yes.
It's such
a simple lyric, actually.
Yeah.
I mean, it's silly to be proud of it, but I am. It's just the lyric is I love it. simple as that. Just with a little tune underneath.
Yeah.
Like, I love it.
Yeah.
I love it, I love it, I love it.
Yeah.
I love it, I love it, I love it. I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it, I love it. Of course, you need all that.
Yeah.
You need all the other people there at the same time. Yeah. It's no good just doing it. Al Policello, whatever it is.
Yeah. Fair enough. Now, what about your film career? Because that's been a bit up and down, hasn't it?
I think I made a mistake in accepting the parts I did.
Yeah.
I should never have played Edward the Confessor.
Yes. Yeah.
I was a loss. It wasn't my territory.
No. Now, you've been very interested in the environment.
Yeah,
haven't you?
I love it. I love it. The environment.
Yeah.
Can't get too much of it.
Yeah.
It is such a great thing to have. And we are the only species in the world, Clive, who systematically goes around destroying it.
Yeah.
You won't get a white bait going, say, you know,
no.
Let's find. You won't find an anchovy going into the rainforest and saying, let's tear it all down
for
another hotel.
True enough.
But only man.
Yeah.
And without the environment, we would not be able to live. Yeah. This is my view.
Yes.
And that's why I think we should sucker it, harbour it, look after it, as if it was our own child.
And of course, you have your own anchovy.
Child, yes, I have my own child.
Yeah, no, but you have your own anchovy farm, don't you?
Yeah, it's just a small contribution to the environment. It's an unnatural salt lake which I've built in Hertfordshire, where I've got anchovies, millions of them, swimming around and breeding, and it takes a bit of money to keep going, but it's lovely to see them happy. And the swans, the black swans fly over, swoop. And I said, don't you dare! Don't you dare! Yeah. I'm saving these little creatures, and just because you're peckish, mate, doesn't mean I'm not going to blast you out of the sky if you don't mind.
Yeah.
There is.
You've come a long way from
I've come a long way from my early days.
Yeah, those early rocking days, country house and everything.
Yeah, I love the country. We were lucky enough to have a place in the country very near town. So we've got the best of everything, really.
Yeah.
And Laura adores it. You know,
she's just
my wife.
You're a fifth wife, isn't it?
Yeah, she's came after the fourth one. And
she's
a beautiful woman. Very wise.
Yeah.
Very, very wise. Yeah. Probably got more wisdom in her than I have.
Yeah. That's possible. Now, I've got to ask you, because I won't be forgiven if I don't know, is there any chance of Ye Gods reforming?
What can I say?
Well, yes or no would be handy.
It's on the cards.
It's on the cards.
There's a big gig for the environment in 2004.
Right.
And we're hoping to get everyone mulled in and melded out and get them all in from all over the world and get them all on the stage and just play that stuff again.
Okay. Man. Well, I want to be there.
Be there, Clive.
Okay. Yeah. Right. Well, thank you very much. Eric Daly.
Our tribute continues in just a moment with a performance.